I always wanted a Home Assistant desktop app that works well on Windows, Linux and Mac, and there is a companion app, but unfortunately it works only on mobile phones and Mac for some reason. Luckily, I found a workaround in the form of a small application that works everywhere. And I'm saying applications because there are two, and you can choose which one suits you best, or you can use both of them. No problems about that. First one is called Home Assistant Desktop, and it is just that, a desktop app that can be run on your computer, but it has some useful features, as you'll see later. The second app is more focused on the assist functionality of Home Assistant and allows sending text and voice commands to your smart home using Home Assistant Assist right from your desktop. The app is called Home Assistant Assist Desktop. But let me explain how I managed to start and configure both applications on Windows, but the steps are the same on Mac and Linux.
Now open the official GitHub repo of the Home Assistant desktop app.
Greetings to the author and the supporters. And of course, you can find the exact link to this GitHub repo in the video description.
This is how the app looks like on macOS. This is on Windows. And I'm looking for the installation section. Here it is. I'll open the releases in another tab, and these are the packages that I need.
Unfortunately, the last version is almost a year old, but anything is working good, and I hope this will be supported in the future.
We have package for Linux, for macOS, and for Windows 64-bit and 32-bits. I'll download this one because my system is like that. Okay, my package is downloaded. I'll open it and I'll double click on it. This is the installer. I'll tick this private network such as my home network and I'll allow access. And here it is. This is the icon of the Home Assistant desktop. I can left click on it to show this initial setup screen. Or I can right-click on it to show the settings. I can add another instance. I can hover to show. I can set stay on top. I can start this app at Windows login. I can enable shortcuts to faster showing this app on my screen. And I can use the attached window and full screen. I can enable or disable automatic updates, and I can open the GitHub project, as well as I can restart and reset the application, and I can quit. Let's try. I'll enter the HTTP, then the IP and the port of one of my test Home Assistant instances, and I'll click on submit. Then I have to authenticate. Come on, what's my... Okay, and here it is. This is my test Home Assistant. Everything is shown here. I can resize it like that, and I can make it full screen. Alt Control Enter. This is the full screen. I can exit the full screen using this shortcut, Alt Control Enter. I can add another instance from here and the port. I have to authenticate again. And this is it. Now, how can I switch between instances? This is the way. I can select either the 5 IP or the 2 IP and it will be switched. What else I can do? I can use detached window and I can move it like that. I can resize it. Good, it is working. This is not bad. I can set stay on top and that way this will stay always above my other windows, I can use the assist from here.
Have in mind that this is not an official app, it is community-driven open source thing like most of the projects on GitHub.
And everything seems legit and good working.
Unfortunately, this Home Assistant desktop app is not quite like the official Home Assistant companion app, which once installed on your Mac, is activating a bunch of sensors in Home Assistant and allows monitoring of things like current location, battery level if it is a laptop, network state, and many more things. On the other hand, with Home Assistant desktop, you just have a quick access to your Home Assistant. But is it quicker and more convenient than the regular web access? I don't know, maybe you can tell me how you feel it in the comments. Next, let's talk about Home Assistant Assist Desktop, which was the second app that I want to show you today. This is how the Home Assistant Assist Desktop is looking like in a nutshell. I'm looking for the installation section here. I'll open the releases link in a new browser tab. At the time of shooting this video, the latest version is 1.1.3. But if you're watching this in the future, then hello, future man. How are the things up? Hope that everything is great. Subscribe if you haven't done that already. And after this, I'll scroll down a bit and here are the assets. From here, I can download the ready-to-use package for Windows, Linux and Mac. .x is for Windows and I'll download that and I'll double click on the download executable file. I had to click next several times here to install the app on my Windows. We have auto start checkbox here and Home Assistant URL and Home Assistant long lived token. I will get the token first. I'll go to my Home Assistant installation, I'll click on my username and I'll scroll down to the very bottom and I'll click on create token. I'll name this somehow, it doesn't matter, and I'll copy the token. Be aware that this token is shown only once. If you want to retrieve it later, you just have to save it somewhere safe or you have to delete it and recreate another one. There is no way to retrieve it again once you close this window. Okay, I'll paste the token here. One important remark here. If you wish to issue voice commands towards your Home Assistant using this app, you need to have HTTPS access to Home Assistant due to browser security restrictions. This is the same and it is also valid for the regular assist button inside Home Assistant web interface. If you don't do that, the mic button will not work. If you don't have such HTTPS Home Assistant access, you can check some of my video tutorials and you have that in no time. And I'll change the Home Assistant URL with mine. I will type my free DuckDNS subdomain, but I'll censor it in post-production because I don't want someone to see my top secret Home Assistant automations and scripts. If you wish to see them anyways, then register for my upcoming webinar about Home Assistant at https://automatelike.pro/webinar. And here it is. So, as summary, Home Assistant URL is needed, preferably a secured one, starting with HTTPS and not with HTTP only, and a long-lived access token is needed for the Home Assistant Assist desktop to work. It seems that it is connected now, which is perfect. Let's try it out. Turn on kitchen lights. And it is working. You can see behind me that the lights are turned on. Let's try the mic. Turn off kitchen lights. No, the mic is not working. Probably the issue here is in me only because I'm connecting to this Windows computer via remote desktop. And I'm not sure if the mic is working properly. And I'm not sure that I set up the remote connection properly. On top, I'm using a Raspberry Pi 4 to run this Home Assistant instance. And the Raspberry Pi 4 can handle
local speech to text and text to speech processing very slowly. I can change the pipelines from here. If I click on this chat box or what it is, I don't know. I can select different one, but let's try it one more time. Turn on kitchen lights. Probably if I was a Nabucasa user, that the Home Assistant cloud service, which provides cloud pipeline, speech to text and text to speech pipeline that answers immediately. This would work perfectly, but this is not the case with me. I'm not such an user. I'm not paying a monthly fee to have this feature. If you are, maybe you can test this and you can share in the comments what are your results. This was Windows. You can do the same on Mac and Linux. But again, if you are a macOS user with Apple Silicon, just get the official Home Assistant companion app and thank me later. If you are a Linux user, you probably already know how to install Linux programs, and these two packages will not be any issue for you. Nevertheless, if you have some difficulties, write them in the comments and I'll try to help. And if some of the terms that I'm using are not so clear for you, you can lift the fog by downloading my smart home glossary, which is absolutely free, and it comes as one big PDF file that I prepared for you. Just go to automatelike.pro/glossary and it is yours. Thanks for watching. I'm Kirill. See you next week. Bye.